problem they have given, LOM is a straight line, find the x value. So this is also, this problem also, okay, SSC CGL previous question. So you know that if it is a straight line, it forms a...
If this video is useful to you, please subscribe and click the bell icon, select all to get all my new video notifications.
So hi friends, in today's class I am going to discuss about geometry. This concept is very important for competitive or school students or the college students. This is very very important topic. So most of the students they skip the geometry, but you should know this geometry. Why? Because it's very 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 important in your future or in a competitive exam. At the same time, who are preparing for NTPC Group D, okay, RRB Group D and NTPC, okay, you will get 2 to 3 marks from this geometry topic, 2 to 3 marks, okay. In today's class, I am going to discuss about angles topic. So, types of angles I am going to discuss. Okay, these basics are very important. From these basics, they are asking one question. Based on angles, they are asking one question. Please watch this video till the end. Don't skip this video. Okay, now, first line. So, line has no endpoints. Line has no endpoints. So, there are infinite number of points lies on a line. So, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, infinite number of lines. Okay, we define a line with a length but no width or no breadth for a line. Now, this is the line. Now, what are the perpendicular lines? Suppose, this is A and this is B. Now, draw a one line that is right angle to the AB. Now it meets at a point O. Now here you can say that AB perpendicular to the AB perpendicular to, suppose here OC, you can write that is OC. So that means these two are said to be perpendicular to each other. These two lines are said to be perpendicular to each other, and these said to be perpendicular lines. Perpendicular lines. So perpendicular lines, if they are perpendicular to each other, the angle is 90 degrees. Now we move into angles. So first one, acute angle. So what is acute angle? See here. Here O is called a vertex. O is called vertex here. Theta is a angle. Now, if this theta lies between 0 and 90 degrees, then this angle is said to be acute angle. If theta lies between 0 and 90 degrees, then this is said to be acute angle. Now, see here. So, right angle. Theta. If theta equal to 90 degrees, then it is said to be right angle. If theta equal to 90 degrees, then it is said to be right angle. Now, next, third one. So, third one, theta O. If theta lies between 90 degrees to 180 degrees, then it is said to be obtuse angle. Obtuse angle. If theta lies between 90 to 180 degrees, then it is said to be obtuse angle. Next. Theta. Now here, theta equal to 180 degrees, then it is said to be straight angle. Okay, if angle is said to be straight angle, then theta equal to 180 degrees. Next. Theta. Now here, this is called, here theta lies between 180 and 360. If theta lies between 180 and 360, then it is said to be reflex angle. Okay, If theta lies between 180 degrees to 360 degrees, then it is said to be reflex angle. The theta lies between 180, okay, 180 to 180 above and 360 less than, okay, between. So 181 starts from 181, 180 above. 180 above and 360 below, then all are said to be reflex angles. Next. So, theta. Here, theta equal to 360 degrees, this is called complete angle. Okay, if theta equal to 360 degrees, then it is said to be complete angle. These are the basically we use terms, types of angles. So, acute angle, obtuse angle, and straight angle, next reflex angle, and complete angle. Now, see here, two important angles we use here. Complementary angles. Complementary angles are nothing but, see here, theta 1 and theta 2. So, here O, A and B. If theta 1 plus theta 2 equal to 90 degrees, theta 1 plus theta 2 equal 90 degrees, these two angles are said to be complementary angles. For examples, if theta 1 equal to 45 degrees, if two angles are complementary, one angle is theta 1, then what about that theta 2? So if two angles are said to be complementary angles, if theta 1 is equal to 45, automatically theta 2 equal to, just you write down 45 plus theta 2 equal to 90 degrees. So theta 2 equal to 90 minus 45 degrees, that equal to 45 degrees. Okay, if two angles are said to be complementary, their sum is 90 degrees. Their sum equal to 90 degrees. Next. Supplementary angles. Supplementary angles. So, see here. Theta 1 and theta 2 here. If sum of the angles equal to, sum of the two angles equal to 180 degrees, then they are said to be supplementary angles. So, in previous case, complementary angles. Here in this case, supplementary angles. If one is supplement to each other, if one is complement to each other, if two angles are, sum of the two angles equal to 180 degrees, then they are said to be supplementary angles. Now suppose, two angles are supplement to each other. If theta 1 is equal to 105 degrees, then find the theta 2 value. So here 105 plus theta 2 equal to 180 degrees. So theta 2 equal to 180 minus 105. So our 75 is the answer. So if two are supplementary each other, if two angles are supplementary to each other, their sum is 180 degrees. Simply you can find, okay, by using this small formula. So complementary is nothing but theta 1. If two angles are complementary and supplementary, so complementary is nothing but theta 1 plus theta 2 equal to 90 degrees. Supplementary is nothing but theta 1 plus theta 2 equal to 180 degrees. These are very, very important. These are very important points. Okay. Now see here, L and M are two parallel lines. N is called here transversal. When here N is intersecting the two parallel lines, here this is called transversal. So it forms an angle. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now see here, these are very, very important, okay, corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. So angles made by this transversal with two parallel lines, that is L and M. So, different types of angles here formed, that is, we can call them, okay, one type are corresponding angles. So what are the corresponding angles here? Corresponding angles and vertically opposite angles. And third one, alternate angles. So corresponding angles, vertically opposite angles and alternate angles. Now see here, what are the corresponding angles here? So 1 and 5, angle 1 and angle 5. Next, these are corresponding angles. Next, 2 and 6. Next, angle 3 and angle 7. Next, angle 4 and angle 8. These are said to be corresponding angles. Corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal here. Corresponding angles are equal. That means angle 1 equal to angle 5, angle 3 equal to angle 7, angle 2 equal to angle 6. Angle 4 equal to angle 8. Here 1 and 5, 3, 7, 3, 2 and 6, 4 and 8. You can write here, these are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. So next, vertically opposite angles. 2 and 4, vertically opposite angles. They are equal. Next, 1 and 3. Vertically opposite angles. Next, angle 6 equal to angle 8. Next, angle 5 equal to angle 7. These are called vertically opposite angles. Next, alternate angles. Alternate angles are equal. So 3 and 5. Angle 3 equal to angle 5. Next, angle 4 equal to angle 6. Here alternate are interior and exterior. Alternate exterior, alternate interior. Here these 3 and 5, 4 and 6 are called interior. Alternate interior angles, alternate exterior angles. So alternate exterior angles are equal. That means angle 2 equal to angle 8. Next, angle 1 equal to angle 7. So these are very very important. Corresponding angles are equal. Vertically opposite angles are equal. Alternate interior angles are equal. Alternate exterior angles are equal. So corresponding angles are 1 equal to angle 1 equal to angle 5, angle 3 equal to angle 7, angle 2 equal to angle 6, angle 4 equal to angle 8 here. So alternate interior, alternate exterior, vertically opposite angles are equal. Some of the interior angles of same side. That means angle 3 plus angle 6 equal to 180 degrees. Next, angle 4 plus angle 5 equal to 180 degrees. Next, some of the exterior are same side equal to 180 degrees. Now angle 2 plus angle 8 equal to angle 2 plus angle 7. Angle 7 equal to 180 degrees. Angle 1 plus angle 8 equal to 180 degrees. So some of the interior angles of same side. Some of the exterior angles of same side that equal to 180 degrees. Very important points these are. So corresponding angles are equal. Vertically opposite angles are equal. Next, alternate interior, alternate exterior angles are equal. Now some of the interior angles of same side equal to 180 degrees. Some of the exterior angles of same side equal to 180 degrees. These are very very important points while doing the problems. Now see the problem here. 3x plus 5 degrees, x plus 5 degrees, find the x value. Now it is looking to be a straight angle. You know that how it is looking to be? It is looking to be a straight angle. Straight angle is nothing but 180 degrees. Now see here, sum of these two angles equal to 180 degrees. 3x plus 15 plus x plus 5, that equal to 180 degrees. 3x plus x, 4x, 15 plus 5 is 20, so 180 degrees, 4x equal to 180 minus 20 degrees, so 160, 4x equal to, x equal to 160 by 4, so x equal to 40 degrees. So here, we should know the concept, that is these two angles, sum of these two angles should be a 180 degrees, that means straight angle. Then only you can do this problem. This is a previous SSC CGL question. Previous SSC CGL question. SSC CGL question. Now see here, third problem. This also a previous question. Angle beta angle alpha here. What is the condition? If angle beta equal to 3 angle alpha, find alpha. Angle alpha. So see here, these alpha plus beta are straight angles. So alpha, angle alpha plus angle beta are straight angles. That means they are equal to 180 degrees. Alpha plus beta, already given. Alpha, angle beta equal to 3 alpha, that equal to 180 degrees. So now, see here, alpha plus 3 alpha, that is 4 alpha, that equal to 180 degrees. So, angle alpha equal to 180 degrees by 4. So, you will get 45 degrees. Angle alpha equal to 45 degrees. So, friends, these are the previous problems based on this topic. Okay? We'll discuss in next video some more problems on angles. And I will introduce in next video new topic. If this video is useful to you, please like, share and subscribe, friends. Thank you.